Did 3 goals by the Bobcats. They had 15 shots to 10 for UMass. And face-offs, Quinnipiac with a slight edge there. There was only one penalty in that period.
Yeah, Billy, and that was killed off beautifully.
Greetings from the Bobcats.
Just want to wish my friends and family happy holidays back in beautiful Southern California.
I want to wish all my fellow classmates and fans a happy Thanksgiving, as well as my relatives and friends back home in Minnesota. Happy Thanksgiving and happy holidays.
All right, there you see Spencer Heichman wishing them happy Thanksgiving back in Yorba Linda, California. The other guy was Eric Hartzell, the freshman goaltender. He and Zach Hansen, both from White Bear Lake, Minnesota.
That just sounds cold, doesn't it?
It does. We're heading toward the third period. Second intermission here at the TD Bank Sports Center. Quinnipiac with a 3-1 lead over UMass. The Bobcats currently enjoying their highest national ranking in the program's history. They're ranked number 9 in the country this week. And while the attention is sweet, the players, especially the seniors, know the real games are won on the ice, not in the newspaper.
With the puck, shot, score!
It's fun to see. You know, it's good to have a number next year, you know, your name when you're on TV and stuff like that and in the papers. But, you know, it's hard to get there, and it's really easy to fall out of there.
I don't even honestly know what we're ranked, but I don't pay much attention to any of that kind of stuff. Stats are kind of beside the point. The main thing is winning, and I mean, I just want to win.
Yeah, you know, there's definitely a buzz going, and it's exciting, but I mean, ultimately, we got to get ready for the next game.
Our goal is to win hockey games, and you know, we're not going to do that by looking at articles and rankings, you know. So yeah, we're just going to keep playing hard, and that's what we do.
We've played hard, we've played well. I think even in some of the games where we've struggled, like some of our off games, we've still found a way to win, which is the mark of a good team.
You know, last year's group, we weren't consistent. You know, this year it's a different feeling. You know, it's almost like there's an extra boost in the room, and you know, it feels like we're ready to go every night.
For myself, I was trying to work my tail off, game in, game out, practice in, practice out, to get in the lineup. And you know what, I think everyone's been doing that, and that's a huge part of our success.
You know, we weren't satisfied with the year we had, and we didn't want to do the same thing this year. So, you know, a lot of guys changed their attitudes, and you know, we want to get out there and win games.
Down by Trentowski, shot by Beaumont, and score.
Our freshmen are a big difference. You know, we have 13 of them. They bring a kind of, you know, freshness to the team, a spark.
Yeah, they've been very good. You know, they've, you know, the whole class has really contributed, the goalies, the forwards, and the D, and we needed them to. We lost a lot of players.
They're expected to come in and contribute, you know, just as the older guys do, not just on the ice, but off the ice.
One of the more important things is our seniors have provided good leadership and kind of shown them the way, and especially the 5 senior forwards have done an outstanding job for us and taken some of the pressure off of those freshman forwards from having to score.
You know, and I think all the freshmen are getting a lot better, and I think we're going to look better and better as the season goes along.
With the puck, shot, score!
No question, our energy level is very high right now. Competitiveness is excellent. And a lot of that credit, I think, goes to Jean-Marc Baudouin and our other captains and seniors. Like, the guys are just buying in right now.
We're going to have to keep proving ourselves. You know, there's a lot of doubters out there, but we're a great hockey team, and I think we're going to do whatever it takes to win games.
So we got to try to find a way to sustain that level, and if we do, we'll have a very good year.
Well, so far, so good for the Bobcats. 7 straight wins, 11-1 record, top of the ECAC. So you're up by 2 goals heading into the third period. If you're Coach Rand Pecknold, what do you tell your team? Now let's take a little listen into the locker room of the Quinnipiac Bobcats.
We're going to watch if this puck doesn't come back for the one-timer, so we're going to stay in our shot-blocking lanes. In our backside forward, you got to get back down on the front of the net. Right, we all know how to do this, correct? So they want to throw that down here, and they want to go to the back door. Be aware of this guy coming in too. Once the puck goes down to here, that forward is also going to start collapsing. Pretty simple, right? Nothing we didn't expect. They'll do the same thing with the two righties over here. Best thing we can do, best way to kill it, let's just stay out of the box, okay? Now, to simplify the game, so far tonight, our competitiveness has been great, it's been good, and it's been just okay. And if you want to beat a team this good, you want to beat a team like this good, it can't be just okay. Is that fair to ask?
Yeah.
It needs to be great. We got 20 minutes of hockey left right now. There's no reason we don't leave anything out there on the ice, correct?
Yeah.
Let's get after it and get it done.
Let's go.
All right, he started with X's and O's and ended up with the Newt Rockne at the end there, Rich. Atkinson. Atkinson comes in deep. Backhand shot, a stop by Dayton. Out in front it goes. Shot long. Score!
Well, Juan gets the winning goal, Billy, but it was Atkinson who used his speed to get around the defenseman to get the puck deep, and then Juan just shows up and scores the most important goals of the game, the tying goal and the goal with 2:40 to go, two to go in overtime to win the game. Atkinson was all by himself, used his speed right here to get around the D, get the puck in front, and then Juan jumps on the loose puck and buries it. Brandon Wong wins it 5-4 in a tremendous hockey game that goes in Quinnipiac's favor.
So Bobcats win it in overtime. Brandon Wong scores the tying goal at the end of regulation. He scores the overtime winner. And Mr. Wong, along with Rand Pecknold, downstairs with the Maven, Bill Mecca. Billy?
Coach, didn't take you long to make the decision. You were pulling the goalie going 6-on-4 in that power play.
Yeah, I just saw with, I think it was like 2:28 left, you know, you don't want to lose an opportunity. I know it's a little risky, but we've been playing well. We played well all night long offensively. You know, Dayton was great when he got in there. He made some saves, and certainly we need to clean up the defensive zone a little bit. But I felt offensively like we were going to get the puck. So, you know, we pulled him early.
It was a great call and a great score, and we got the guy who scored the goal right here. Brandon, big goal, that one there, to get into overtime. Talk about that one.
Oh, that felt good. Langer, all I know is the puck went beyond the net, and Langer won a battle and put it out front, and it was just right there, and I just shoveled it in and tried to raise it the puck as much as possible, and it went in. And
great win for Quinnipiac hockey, huh?
Oh, great win.
Back upstairs, fella. Good call today.
All right, thanks, Billy. And, Rich, quite an effort there, both of these teams. Again, we talked about number 9 against number 10, and it lived up to its billing.
Oh, it did. And more so, Billy, I thought both teams put on a great show for the fans. They both played well, both played so hard. And I think from Quinnipiac's standpoint, sure, Rand Pecknold doesn't want to see that you lose a 3-goal lead. Those things are going to happen. It's how you react to that. They tied the game late, winning overtime, and you start to build character as the season goes on. This is a great character builder.
It is, no question about it. So the Bobcats win it, and our final score once again, Quinnipiac 5, UMass 4 in overtime. Join us for the next Quinnipiac telecast on NESN. That'll be Tuesday, December the 8th at 7 o'clock when the men's basketball team takes on Rhode Island. For Rich Coppola, Bill Mecca, and our entire crew, this is Bill Schweitzer saying so long, everybody. Thanks for watching.
You're one.